Hi, the Pragmatic Luther, making a short video today to tell you that I actually do make these things. I don't just stand around in front of the camera and talk about it. So today's video is just a short trip around to see what's going on in the shop, what's on the bench on this particular day. Enjoy. I'm building a classical guitar for a client. This is a Douglas fir top, something a little unusual for a classical guitar, I think. But the inside of this top is modeled after Ignacio Fleta. Ignacio Fleta's guitars were very popular. And by today's standards, if you can get your hands on one, I think probably about a $40,000 item. Fleta has been dead for a number of years. I like these guitars. They were quite famous for being loud and very bright and clear. And I had the good fortune 51 years ago now to play an original Ignacio Fleta, which is quite rare because, you know, guitars of that quality and price range, you don't find them at the average music store. So it was really nice to be able to play that. And I think it left me with an impression. So today what I did was I carved my braces and shaped them as I believe I want them. And I've done all of the shaping that I believe I can legitimately do. And by legitimately, I mean enhancing tone and arriving at a pitch without sacrificing the strength that we need here. And I'm getting a tone as I tap. I don't know if the lavalier mic can pick that up, but I'm getting a tone that is on the tone series. And I demonstrate that with my iPhone. I've got a tone generator that I compare to. So things are looking very good. What I'm listening for as I'm tapping after I've arrived at a pitch is I'm after sustain. And what I'm hearing is an initial burst of tone from when I excite the top. But then after that, I'm hearing the tone continue and then almost ripple again, like a second layer that deteriorates somewhat slowly. And that's pretty much what I'm after. That's what my mental database and building tells me that I want to hear. So the proof will be in the pudding when this is completely done, but I think it's going to be quite a nice guitar. And I have the back for that classical guitar. This is Black Cherry. And I just finished refining the braces a few minutes ago. I have this responding at 138 hertz. And what I'm hearing as I'm tapping this is not just the response at a given hertz, but I want to hear, for this guitar, I want to hear a very percussive startup tone. In other words, I want that tone to jump right out. That is an indication to me that the back is very reflective. The air is going to hit it. It's going to bounce off very quickly. In the case of a classical guitar, I think that's very, very important because the polymer strings being at lower tension, getting those trebles out of that instrument is a little more challenging than it would be in a steel string guitar. My bracing is a little bit different, and I'm going to turn the camera and show you that up close in the next segment. I don't know that what I'm doing with my back braces is unique or even terribly unusual, but I like to do this a lot. I feel the need quite often to stiffen my braces, and I do that by adding a laminate strip in the center of each one, in this case, Black Cherry. The outside is Western Red Cedar, and I use a sandwich here of equal thicknesses each time, you know, 1/3 each for a 5/16 brace in this case. And I like what it does in two ways. I do like the look that the client sees or the owner sees when they view the inside of the guitar, but I think this nicely stiffens the back without adding a tremendous amount of weight to it. I like the effect that it's had over the years that I've done it, so I'm going to keep doing it. Over here, I've got the rim for this instrument, also in black cherry, of course, and this is something that I have not done before. I'm using a basswood laminated rim, single piece. When we get this all done, it's not kerfed. And I believe I'm going to like these a lot. I'm doing it to this guitar because these stiffen the rims significantly enough so that you are effectively enlarging the vibrating surface of the top without increasing the size of the guitar. So I'm excited about using these. I've never done it before, and I'm real happy. I think it's going to be a good improvement. You can see a finished one that's glued in here permanently, and I round them over on the shaper and clean them up nice, and then I rub a little bit of just a wash coat of lacquer sealer on those. Gives them a nice appearance, I think. Here's the other layer. I just glued these up about 5 or 10 minutes ago. In the works also, we have this jumbo guitar that I'm doing for a client. This is a full 18-inch jumbo. This is soft maple, Acer saccharinium, as opposed to Acer saccharum, which is hard maple. There's the back to it. And here in the clean room, we have, this is an 8-string baritone that's being done for a client. In fact, this is a return client. He has another guitar of mine. This one is in curly maple. And there's the neck for it. And over here, this is actually a mate to the classical guitar. They're both going to the same client. The classical guitar will not have the arm bevel, but this is Douglas fir with a cherry back and rim. And there's the neck, of course. And lastly, my own guitar. You've seen this one in a previous video or so. This is also a Doug fir top. And this one you probably saw behind me. This is yellow wood. And this is really unusual. This is a southern tree, really. This guitar is very, very close to being finished. It just needs to be buffed out and assembled and have the bridge made for it. There's the neck for it there. So I'm excited about this guitar, but I get caught up in the other projects and I don't like to work on mine until I feel I'm caught up enough. So that's what's happening today, April 2nd, 2023. At Ledoux Guitars. I'm Kevin Ledoux, the Pragmatic Luthier. I hope you'll put a like on this short video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks very much for watching.